2012 Ram 3500. We're going to put out a 6-inch top gun custom forearm kit, and we're going to set a 37-inch Toyota MT zone.
First thing before we get it jacked up, we get the wheels hauled off, you're going to want to disconnect the sway bar. Okay, now you're going to want to chalk your rear tires. Then you're going to want to get the truck jacked up, get a set of jack stands under it, and start taking the front wheels off.
Next, you're going to take off your drag link and the nut for the pivot arm. All right, now you're going to want to put a puller on your pivot arm to pull the pivot arm off. All right, now you're going to have to disconnect your track bar. Now you're going to go ahead and undo the shock tower. Okay, now you're going to want to remove the shock tower mount, and then you can pull the spring out, lower the jack. Okay, now you're going to want to remove the lower control arms. Okay, now we're going to pull the stock lower control arms out and get ready to install the new ones. Okay, now you're going to have to take the upper control arm out, but the passenger side upper bolt has to be cut. They're going to give you a new bolt. Once you can cut that out, so the exhaust is in the way, you're going to pull that out and put your new one in with the supplied bolt. Okay, you can tell the difference in the spring. This is the lifted spring, that's the stock spring. You're going to want to mount it with the compressive rate down. You're going to need this ring on the top when you put it in. And you're going to want to lower that. But okay, now that you have your springs in, you're going to go ahead and drop your shocks in. Then you're going to want to put your shock towers back in place. Alright, now you're going to take and install the track bar drop bracket. You have one bolt that goes up here through the frame, another bolt that goes in through here. Then you're going to want to tighten it down a little bit. Okay, now you're going to want to go ahead and support your axle on the jack stands now that you have your shocks, your coil springs in. Go ahead and tighten up all the bolts on your control arms. Okay, now you're going to put your pivot arm on. Tighten the bolt down and reinstall your drag link. Okay, now you're going to want to go ahead and put your sway bar end links on and tighten them down. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and grease our control arms bushings up. Make sure you get all four of them. gonna go ahead and mount our 37 inch Toyos. It's gonna give us a little play with the steering wheel to mount our track bar.
Okay, you're gonna chock the front wheels, get the back of the truck lifted up, take the stock U-bolts out, and you're gonna lower the axle, put your lift blocks in, and then your U-bolt.
Now you're gonna go ahead and tighten up your new U-bolts after you get them in. Crisscross pattern, don't go in a circle. Okay, now you're going to want to go ahead and install the rear shocks and get them tightened up.